because that devotee had written to Swami, "Swami, have you forgotten us? We are all poor devotees. You have better devotees to think about. So you have forgotten us." So in response to that mail, Swami writes a sweet mail. Swami says, "How can you say like this? I've been very busy. Do you know how many people are coming here? There are thousands of people coming to the mandir. And I'm waking up at 4 in the morning. I'm sleeping at, late in the night." And all of that, Swami writes. And then Swami says, "Don't worry, I will come." Last time we had spoken about this couple. They had come to Swami after an extended disaster in their family. The wife of Madhoji Rao had given birth to 7 sons, and each one of those sons had died few days after birth. You can imagine what trauma that couple would have gone through, what trauma the mother would have gone through. For the 8th time when she was pregnant, they come to Swami, and Swami materializes grapes and gives it to this mother and says, "Don't worry, this son will be born healthy and he will live." And Swami says, "I will come and name him." 8th of March, the child is born. And Swami had promised, "I'll come and visit the child." So what did Swami do? He went straight to the hospital. He went to Vani Vilas Hospital in Bangalore to see the child. And Swami saw the child, blessed the child and the mother. Later, I think in April, Swami goes to his house in Chamrajpet in Bangalore. Swami names the child Satya Sai Nath. And the teacher in the school says the name is too big and makes Satya Sai Nath into Satish. We generally say, man proposes, God disposes. This is the other way around. Then God proposed a name and man seems to have contorted it.